Hi friends!
Say I give your friend rupees 100 and ask him to buy 3 commodities, sandwiches, chips and a few chocolates. The prices for which are chocolate for rupees 8, sandwich for rupees 16 and chips for rupees 12. And now, if I ask you the question, how much quantities of each product will your friend buy? Well, your answer might be, I don't know, that's up to him. But if I ask you the question, on what basis will he decide how much quantity of each product to buy? Tricky question, right? Don't worry, all your questions will be answered. Welcome to the Sagar Rao channel, and today we'll learn the law of equimarginal utility. Assuming that your friend is normal, he'll try to spend his income on all 3 commodities in such a way that he attains maximum satisfaction. And the way he'll do it is by applying this formula, that is, by equating the ratio of marginal utility to price of all 3 commodities. Don't worry, you'll understand it in a while. For now, just remember that your friend has to spend rupees 100 on all 3 commodities in such a way that he attains maximum satisfaction. Let's assume that you're given with the marginal utilities your friend derives from the additional units of sandwich. Which means, when your friend eats first sandwich, he gets 128 units of utility. From the second sandwich, his utility decreases to 96 units, and so on. Now, to find the ratio, we need to apply this formula, that is, marginal utility upon price. We know that the price of the sandwich is rupees 16 and the marginal utility from the first sandwich he derives is rupees 128. Hence, the ratio will translate to 8. Similarly, let's say we have the data for marginal utilities of chips and chocolates as well. Now, if possible, pause the video and please try to understand the schedule first so that it's easier for you to grasp what's next. Okay? Alright, remember, as a rational consumer, your friend will try to equate the ratio of marginal utility to price of the 3 commodities. Let's say your friend equates the ratio of 8 of the 3 commodities. In that case, he'll be consuming 1 sandwich of rupees 16, 2 sandwiches for rupees 24 and 3 chocolates for rupees 24. However, by doing this, your friend is not spending the entire 100 rupees but only 64 rupees. And we wish to know, how will he spend his rupees 100 to gain maximum satisfaction? Okay, let's try it with the second ratio. Let's say your friend tries to equate the ratio of 6. In that case, your friend will have to buy 2 sandwiches worth rupees 32, 3 chips worth rupees 36 and 4 chocolates worth rupees 32. This way, he'll be spending his entire 100 rupees. So, what does this mean? Remember our original question of how will your friend allocate rupees 100 to gain maximum satisfaction from it? So, given rupees 100, your friend will buy 2 units of sandwich, 3 units of chips and 4 chocolates to gain maximum satisfaction. The law of equimarginal utility is actually based on many assumptions. However, the assumptions that you all need to know are of rationality and cardinal utility. Rationality states that your friend is a complete normal person and he does everything as a normal person and nothing superhuman or extraordinary. Secondly, remember, from the first video of consumer behavior in utility analysis, we learned that utility can only be measured ordinally. That is, we cannot give numbers and say that I got 10 units of satisfaction from this commodity or 20 units of satisfaction from the other commodity. We can only say that I liked certain commodity more or something less. However, in this law, we assume that cardinal measurement of utility is possible. Hope you liked the video, guys. If you did, then do press the like button and also the subscribe button. And don't forget to comment on this video. Till then, adios. Hasta la vista.